Hi YouTube, Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and today I am filling boxes. Actually, we started filling these the other night. We put a layer of gravel down with some landscape fabric over the top, and then we filled these up with, well, let me show you what we filled it with. And it was kind of funny because we were worried about having enough to fill these boxes up, and one bucket load would do two boxes to the level that we wanted. And Tim joked, we need more boxes. No, we don't. Anyway, so this is the first layer. Well, actually the second layer after the gravel layer. And then what I'm doing today is I'm adding some leaf mold. And my neighbors right next door have this huge pile of leaves in their little no man's land between our houses. And I asked him, I said, are you guys going to use that? And he said, no. And I said, do you mind if I have some of it? And he said, no, help yourself. It's this huge, beautiful pile of leaf mold from last fall. And I was feeling guilty because they do have a garden. And I said, you know, you really should spread that on your garden. It'll really help. And he said, no, we got manure and stuff from the steers, so we're good. So he doesn't want it. So I am taking advantage of it. So today I'm just going over and I'm getting two bucket loads will make one box worth. And so that's what I'm doing. I'm working my way down. I have two boxes done and the rest. And then what we're going to do, having some iced tea, what we're going to do from this point on is add topsoil the rest of the way. Now this will settle. This will all settle down. So we should be able to get about 8 inches of topsoil on top. And then after it settles further, I'm hoping to be able to get another layer of this stuff for mulch on top. And by putting this in, this will bring earthworms to our boxes, which, even though I don't like to see them, I don't like worms, I do recognize their value in the garden, so I do want to incorporate them into my boxes, and there's lots of stuff for them to eat in here, and will be. So that's, leaf mold is just great anyway. This whole pile is so wet. The minute you dig into it, it's just moisture. So that's what I'm hoping this is going to do for my boxes, because anytime you have raised beds, what you fight is watering and keeping them well watered, because raised boxes do tend to dry out, I think, faster than other conventional gardening methods. So I'm hoping the leaf mold, a layer of that, will help hold the moisture. And then if I can get another layer on top of the topsoil as a top mulch, I think that's going to do the trick. So let me just show you this pile of leaves I've got to work with. It's like black gold. So I'm going to go get another bucket load, and we'll be back. Okay, there's the hole I've started. Look at this beautiful pile of leaves. It's huge. They have a lot of maples in their yard, but and it's just gorgeous stuff. You can see how dark it is, and it's just wet, even though it's not been dry here, but it's not been exceptionally wet either. So just really nice stuff. A gardener's dream. So I'm going to fill up my little bucket here and carry on. Okay, we got the dirt in the boxes. We were able to use the dirt that was in this bed. You see there's still a little pile of it down there. My husband borrowed this wonderful tool that his brother made. It's like a tumbler, and it sorts all the weeds and rocks out and then dumps or sifts through all the good dirt down below. Is that a potato? Oh my goodness. Part of a potato. Yukon gold. I didn't even plant potatoes last year. Anyway, so he was able to get all the dirt out of this other bed and use it to fill the boxes up. And then he wet them down so they'd settle. I would have liked him to go a little further towards the top, because I think they're going to settle down even further. But this is fine. There's a good 8 inches, but there's a good 6 inches in here. And that will get me started. And then that still leaves me room to put some more mulch on top. So I'm working this weekend. But this week, definitely, I will hope to get my boxes all planted up with my started plants, mainly. Basil and tomatoes, a few tomatoes and peppers, because the bulk of the potatoes, or tomatoes, excuse me, are going to go back in the back garden against a stock panel. But I'm going to put a few in here, because once we do hoop it over in the fall, I want to see how long I can keep the tomatoes going into fall. So I'm going to put just a few pepper plants and a few tomatoes, like one box of each. And then basil will be up here, and cauliflower, and broccoli, and cabbage, and carrots, and ground cherries. And I just can't wait. I just think this is going to be the berries. So I'm excited. I'm really excited. I wanted these for quite a while. And it's just going to make gardening so much easier, I think. I hope. So there you go. I forgot to mention what we're going to do with this area, this patch over here, is Tim's going to smooth it out. And then we're going to put down a 36 foot piece of landscape fabric. And I'm going to be having my potato bags on here. I'm going to grow potatoes in bags this year. I'm tired of digging trenches. Getting old and lazy. I bought some bags, and Tim also wants to try some potatoes in tires. He saw that and he thought that looked intriguing. So I said, sure, we got some old tires around, so we're going to do potatoes in bags and probably one set of tires. And those will be right down through here. That'd be a good place. But we're going to put the landscape fabric down so the weeds don't grow up around the bags, and then try to have to weed whip or mow around them would be a big pain in the butt. So we're going to do that. It won't look that pretty, but it'll be functional. Okay, now I'm really done.